Hey guys, welcome back to my art channel. If you are new, hi, I'm May. This is Eternal Nymphalid, IbisPaint Digital Acrylic Pour with cells. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you like my art and hit the notification button to get weekly updates. I hope everyone's having a good day and let's create some awesome art.
Because this tutorial is in real time, I've decided not to add any music for anyone who would like to follow along with this tutorial. That way you can put any music you like on in the background.
Digital Acrylic Pour. To create this image, you'll be using any brush you like. My list is in the description box to lay down your colors in a random pattern. Choose a color palette of 3 to 6 colors. Play with different colors and brushes to achieve different looks, textures, and styles. Once you lay down your colors randomly on the canvas, you will use either the Effects Filter Options, FX, and or the Liquify Special Pen. You can use one or the other or both together to create a digital acrylic pour. FX options I mainly use are Wave, Ripple, Twirl, and Polar Coordinates. Play around with all the features until you create a design you love. If you don't love how it turned out, delete the layer or hit the back button and keep at it till you have a design you like. Cells. Stamp cells. These cells are created after you finish creating your digital acrylic pour. These cells are made with cell templates that I created myself. If you decided to draw your own templates, you'll insert the image above your digital acrylic pour. Make sure your image is black and white. The parts where you want your cells to show on your digital acrylic pour, make sure those areas are white. The black areas will be erased to show the digital acrylic pour underneath. Once your image is inserted, you'll use the magic wand and select the white areas. Then select the revert selection area option. In the editing window, bottom right of screen, it looks like a white and black box with arrows around it. Next, you will use the erase option and an opaque erase brush to erase over the cell's image with the wand selected area still on. This will erase the black section showing the digital acrylic pour underneath. Next, you will click the revert selection area again so the white cells are the selected area. Now, while the area is selected, you can change the cell's colors to anything you like with the fill bucket or a paintbrush you choose. After coloring your cells, click the dotted square in the top right corner and click remove selected area. Now you can play with the cells with the FX filter options, liquify pen, or merge them with the digital acrylic pour underneath. Watch ahead to see how I create these cells.